So what do you expect, like organizing a Video Olympics contest and not inviting the winner of the Video Olympics to do a video right in Elektor Labs? Mm-hmm. And I've got an announcement to everybody. Mark van Helvoort is here, arrived in the Elektor Labs. And Mark is the great winner of the Elektor Video Olympics with an absolutely interesting and staggering video on practical EMC measurements. Call it like that. Mark, you did a very old design. In fact, it's so old I couldn't find it in my own archive. It dates back to 1997, exactly 20 years ago.
Yes, that's correct. It's a very old design, and actually I also built it a long, long time ago. But I found out that it's still, the measurements we did at that time are still actual, and I wanted to show that to a broader audience, and this was an excellent opportunity to share it with real electronics fans.
Yeah, it was a great success, Mark. Mark, at the time, can you remember in 1997 when you built it, what was your original purpose for the project?
Actually, I have to be fully honest that I did not completely build it myself. I'm great in outsourcing electronics, so it was actually built with two friends of mine, to a large extent. So one of them was Peter Bruins, and he actually went over to Electro to fetch the PCB from you.
So he came to our store?
He came to us, yes, because we were in a hurry at the time. And then it was assembled by another friend of mine, Peter Wouters. He's from Eindhoven University, and he's involved with the EMC group. I also have an EMC background, and at the time there were some questions about magnetic fields stemming from traction transformers and from trams. As you have seen, there was a shielding underneath that building. But there were also questions, what happens when we put a transformer into a building?
Uh-huh.
It was just at that time, 20 years ago, when we talked large screen television, we did not think this dimensions, but we thought about this dimension, that were cathode ray tubes.
Mm-hmm.
And when you put them in such a larger plate, in a slightly increased magnetic field, and you had those color distortions.
Yeah. Mark, at the time, I think if I read correctly, the range of the instruments was like 100 nanotesla to 3 microtesla, something. How did that strike you, the range of the instruments? And it has a couple of simple LEDs as a readout. Did you still think that was suitable for your investigations?
Yes, because when I made this video, I made sure that it was suitable, and nowadays everybody has a mobile phone.
Mm-hmm.
And if you have a modern version like I have, it has a three-dimensional magnetometer.
Yes, but did you
and,
do...
And that makes it mm-hmm. much harder to see what is really happening. You see all those curves going all directions, and with the simple display, yeah. with the simple the view meter principle, it's much more easy to see, okay, here is something really going on, and this is just mm-hmm. a glitch.
Did you do any significant modifications to the hardware? We always ask Elektor fans and Elektor project builders, what do you do with the hardware? How did you? What was your personal modification to the project?
Well, the principle remained the same, but at the time when I built it, I didn't have the proper wire laying in the lab, so I simply took wire with another diameter, but that also means that you're self-inductive over the coil.
You have to recalculate.
You have to recalculate it, and then you get also a different range. So I had to adjust some other components to get more or less the same range, because I wanted to keep the original range. And of course, if you make changes and do calculations, you have to check them. So I also built a rather simple setup with two coils. So that
yes,
you make
so we saw it on the video,
yes,
how you recalibrate the instrument.
Yeah.
Very well done. We are still talking electronics, Mark, and that's very good. So we always ask about triggers
yes.
that people have. First of all, again, back to the memory, 1997
Seven.
Perhaps. What was the trigger exactly to start doing the project?
Well, at the time you could do magnetic measurements with very large equipment.
Very expensive.
And expensive. Well, expensive is not such a big problem.
University.
For university. So that. But if you want to have to go into a building, then people ask, would it here be a problem, or is there here a problem, and you have to go in with a complete van and equipment, it's very inconvenient. And if you can go there with a simple handheld device, look guys, the red light is burning, you have a problem.
Yeah, and an LED readout, of course, you know, has appeal to a general audience.
Yes.
So, second trigger, Mark. What was the trigger to start investigating these DC disturbances, if you like, from trams and trains and stuff?
Well, the trigger at the time is what I already explained, is that you had these large well, besides television screens coming in, which were disturbed by magnetic fields, mm-hmm. So at that time it was important that even the smaller fields were detected and that they were resolved by the owners of the traction company. Uh-huh. And also the building you have seen in the video, there's a tunnel under which a tram goes, and those mm-hmm. currents influence the equipment above in the building.
Yep.
And so they had to retrofit a shielding in between.
Yeah. Third and final trigger, Mark. What was the trigger to participate in the Video Olympics contest?
Well, the big prize was a 3D printer.
Exactly.
So I made a dash for that one, and I'm really happy I didn't receive the FPGA kit.
Okay, fair enough. So you're not into FPGA program at all?
Not myself, no. Okay. I know, but I would have made somebody else very happy, I know, but I'm glad I received the 3D printer from you.
So. Yeah. A very happy winner, Mark van Helvoort, winner of the Video Olympics organized by Elektor. Mark, the prize is well deserved. That's, I think, closes off our little video here in the Elektor Labs. Thank you very much for coming over, and we'll give you the prize. And we'll even help you put it in your car, okay?
Okay, thank you very much.